Well, hello and welcome back, guys, to another one of my Cloak & Dagger videos. And on this video, we're going to be discussing the 7th episode of the 2nd season of the series, which was otherwise titled Vikingtown Sound. Now, first and foremost, I'm going to be traveling on business this coming week, so I might not be able to upload a review next week for Cloak & Dagger. If I don't, that doesn't mean that I'm ignoring the episode or ignoring the series, but I'm going to be trying to kind of incorporate the Easter eggs for that episode on my review of the episode that follows. But that's the only announcement I wanted to make at the beginning of the video, so let's start talking about the episode. Now, I did read the synopsis for the upcoming 3 episodes, and this week's episode seems to be a solid setup for the finale. I know a lot of people have been complaining about Cloak & Dagger, you know, so slow. Tandy is getting more airtime than Tyrone. That's because of last week's episode, which, by the way, from the kind of story that was being told back then, was supposed to be Tandy-centric. I mean, I wouldn't have had it any other way. There was also the complaint about the two of them being quite weak. I think that ship has sailed after this week's episode. They were just realizing their true potential and their true powers, and that's kind of good build-up. I don't call them weak, I call this good build-up. Now, is it the best feature made for television by Marvel? I'm not saying that's the case, by the way. I think it's not up there at all. Like, we've got Daredevil, we've got Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., we've got Legion. But nonetheless, for a series that's supposed to address more young adultish audiences than, you know, our kind of adultish audiences, then yeah, it's pretty decent. But anyway, let's get into the details of this episode, because as of the beginning of the episode, Tandy's got no way out, she's got none of her powers, thanks to Despair over here. And the thing about all of this is it kind of reminds me of their origin story in the comics, hers and Tyrone's. I mean, being abducted, being subjected to drugs. In this case, the drugs were inhaled. On this episode, they were inhaled. But nonetheless, being subjected to drugs while being abducted, that's very much their origin story. Now, over here, they've got their powers years ago, and they've activated at the beginning of season 1. But nonetheless, it is still quite the reference. But on another note, drugs continue to play a major role over here in the subduing of Tandy. Now, every single time you mention drugs in conjunction with none other than Despair, you start thinking D-Light out of the comics, and D-Light in the comics is Despair's drug of choice to use on his victims. Now, we finally get some time with Adina Johnson, love that about this episode. She's sort of grieving all over again when it comes to Billy, faced by his killer right in her kitchen. The performance by the actress in the role, I've gotta say, was amazing for this episode. The moment she starts talking about possibly killing him based on the outcome of some sort of a cost-benefit analysis, like, is he more beneficial for Tyrone alive or does killing him kind of outweigh that? That was yet another well-acted moment. Really loved that moment with Adina. I mean, her grief kind of came full circle on this episode, and this grief we've been watching since season 1.
And we'll see. We'll see if your value to Tyrone outweighs the need for me to end your own life for what you did to Billy.
Now, I know I'm going a little bit random over here, but I'm kind of mentioning a top moment on this episode for every, like, 2 or 3 Easter eggs. So speaking of Easter eggs and references, we've got Leah talking to Tandy about family. Like, all the talk about how no one comes looking for all of these girls, how no one is gonna come looking for her, that's actually a reference to how Tandy has always been distanced from her family, from her mother, to be more specific. And that's both on the series and on the pages of the comics. But speaking of the situation that she's in over here is speaking of the major villain of the season, that being Despair. And when you speak of Despair, Despair in the comics is basically a demon. But when you look at Andre Deshaun over here, he's a mere human, he's just got some powers. So the series is trying to kind of complement that bit in the comics by giving him the opportunity to ascend into becoming a Loa, into becoming a god of sorts. Now, with that having been mentioned, the problem of the season, the issue of the season, is no longer that he's just, you know, selling girls into human trafficking. That's not really the case. I mean, yeah, that's a major problem, but there's a bigger problem at hand here. He's about to become a god with unlimited power compared to the power that he has. It's the question that Chantel kind of raises. If he's doing all of this when he's just playing God, what is he gonna do when he becomes an actual god? So this episode just heightened the stakes, not just for Deshaun, but also for Cloak & Dagger. They've got to stop this guy before he ascends into becoming a Loa, before he ascends into becoming a god, before he unlocks that lock. Now, at the beginning of the episode, and, you know, with all the mayhem that's been going on, with all the chaos that's been going on, and the reports that this little woman has done all of this, has brought about all of this destruction, the first thought that Bridget has is mayhem is back. Now, the moment you hear that on this episode, you kind of start thinking, okay, you know what, mayhem is either gonna be back on this episode or maximum by next week. And that's exactly what happens on this episode. She's still in the, you know, Dark Dimension realm, which, by the way, it seems they're referring to as the lower realm, like an all future synopsis. Like they're basically trying to detach themselves from the movie side of things, Doctor Strange and whatnot. Even though, when you kind of think about it, there is the possibility that Tyrone's got access to multiple realms and multiple dimensions. So the first one would be the Dark Dimension, that's the source of his powers, and then the second one would be the lower dimension. That dual access kind of thing is a possibility when you look at all the voodoo that's been going on when it comes to Tyrone this season. Like, he's been trying to kind of summon the slower early on, Papa Legba, so it is really possible here. But circling back to Mayhem though, she's in Deshaun's record store, she's breaking his records, she's messing with him, and she's also using the records in order to point Tyrone in the right direction in order to find Tandy. Now what I think is going on over here is that the series is kind of trying to present Mayhem in a different light, one that is different than the light that was shed on her since the beginning of this season. You know, someone who is in the comics worthy of being considered for the Avengers initiative at some point, that's Mayhem by the way. So what they're trying to do over here is they're kind of trying to take her from extremely violent vigilante, like borderlining villain, to just extremely violent vigilante, no villainous nature. She's trying to save everyone, she's trying to do the right thing on the trailer of next week's episode, and even though she did try to kill Bridget before, she seems to try to save Bridget as well. Now, with the mention of Mayhem trying to help Tyrone find Tandy, we need to jump back to Tyrone, you know, jumping that guy in that ambulance. All the smoke that his power generates kind of looked black all around him, except for the little bit of the smoke right in front of his face that looked totally green. Now, I think that was there for two reasons. Number one, that was to emphasize that this was all through the help of Mayhem. And number two, that was all towards the effect of her venomous gas in the comics that basically forces people that she uses it on to tell the truth. Now, the hint gets more obvious when Tyrone asks the driver of the ambulance, where is she? And the next thing we know is that Tyrone is driving this ambulance towards the very place that Tandy is being held at. So yeah, you've got a green venomous gas, you've got a question being posed, and you've got the guy giving up the answer. Kind of all adds up. It also happens to work with a certain theme that we're getting on this episode. Tyrone gets a power-up at the end of the episode. He gets his ability to go intangible out of the comics. Tandy does what she could do best and gives that other girl hope, so the hope is kind of reciprocated and is kind of given back to Tandy, so she gets her powers back. So it kind of makes sense that Mayhem as well does get a power upgrade. But before I continue with the list of the possible Easter eggs or other possible Easter eggs on this episode, let me mention this. We've finally gotten a solid action scene at the end of this episode. It might not be the best, but these guys are still kind of understanding their powers, how to use them to the best they can. Another thing over here is that Tyrone is trying to do everything that he can, trying to pull everything that he could, because Tandy is the one in danger, kind of emphasizing what this season has been building towards. You know, these two have got one another's backs, and these two are the ones that matter to one another, and that finally they're not just the two people with the same goals as in last season. You know, one had revenge for her father in her mind, and the other one had revenge for his brother on his mind, but they're a lot more, they're best friends. This episode, in a way, kind of complements last week's episode. Last week, it was Tandy getting to the realization that Tyrone is the best thing and the most important thing that she's got in her life, and Deshaun was basically trying to demolish that thought. And on this week, Deshaun, once again, was trying to demolish this thought at the beginning of the episode, only this time it was Tyrone's thought that all he's got, that the best thing he's got in his life, the best friend, is Tandy. Now we are closing into the end of the season, and there are so many Easter eggs that kind of hint at other villains on this episode and on other episodes to come probably, and I think they're basically setting up for the upcoming season or seasons, depending on how many seasons the series gets renewed for. But for starters, we've got the poster in the record store that reads Parasite. Now the possible thought over here, and since Andre is not really Despair from the comics, but rather this different version of Despair, is that there is this demonic parasite. It is what is giving him his headaches, it is what's causing all of this, and it is the reason behind all of this. So it is kind of the real Despair, a demon within Andre. Now in this episode as well, we do see the Dumbala voodoo sign. Now there's a certain thing going on this season with the talk about societies, you know, when it comes to Connors a couple of episodes ago. When it comes to talking about serpents and vipers, or seeing serpents and talking vipers, like the speech that Tandy was giving, you know, the story about the farmer and the viper and of course the Damballa sign. Now think of this one the way you want to think of it. You don't have to necessarily think of it as an Easter egg, but it is possibly a hint or an Easter egg towards the Serpent Society out of the comics, or towards the possibility that they're setting up a cabal of Fear Lords. Do remember, we did see Mr. Jip on the first season, but he never made it back. So maybe, just maybe, that is something he's going to be part of on the third season, or any other future season for that matter. But that being said though, I've got nothing more to add over here, so let me know in the comments down below what you thought of this week's episode, and let me know if there are any Easter eggs that I missed on this video. Let me know as well if you did like this video by dropping it a much appreciated like, subscribing to this channel, and do make sure while you're at it to enable notifications in order to get updates when I post a new video, publish a new community post, or start a new live stream. But until the next time that you tune in for another one of my videos, Cloak and Dagger or otherwise, thank you so much for tuning into this one, and have a great day.